Yo!
What's up? I'm Adam.
And I'm Patrick.
And we are Gynecube. All right, Patrick. I am super excited. Power BI Data Marts just announced at Build.
Yep.
And we want to walk you through what this is and why you should be paying attention to it.
Stay tuned.
If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both of these guys.
Yeah, that's right.
All right, Power BI Dataflows was just announced at Build 2022. Ooh. Power BI Data Marts is really about self-service data analytics. So it's this idea of bridging the gap between the business user and IT when it comes to databases, those things that business users are not really like all up on.
Self-service data analytics, SSDA, new acronym. You heard it here first.
Okay. Sure. So this idea though of how do I create a data warehouse type thing without having to go to central IT? I just need to stand this up for my business unit. We're not talking about the big data stuff that we normally talk about here.
Anyone can do this inside of Power BI.
Okay.
So you don't need a special skill set. You don't need to create tables.
So it's this idea of no code, low code for the business when it comes to data warehousing or analytics itself, right?
I'm excited.
Patrick, I think it's time.
Enough of all this talking.
Let's
do what? Let's head over to our laptop. To get started, you create a workspace in Power BI. You do need premium per user. And so now, right here, you can use the new button, click the drop down, and you'll see right there where it says Data Mart. Take about 30 seconds sometimes for this to go ahead and create your data mart. Once it's created, right here on the screen, you could decide if you want to use a data flow, Excel, or import data from SQL.
One thing I want to call out here real quick. This is effectively Power Query, right?
Power Query.
We're using Power Query to help with the get data experience to get data into our data mart.
Absolutely.
You can have multiple data sources.
In a single data mart.
We can be pulling data from our existing data warehouse. Maybe there's a SharePoint list out there. Maybe there's some Excel files. Maybe there's an Oracle database out there. Who knows?
We can mix and mingle data sources. I want to show, when I go here, you can see all the data sources, all the possibilities that's available to you. And so if I go ahead and click Excel workbook, because that's where we're going to get our data from, we can click browse my OneDrive, which is really nice. And then I have to authenticate. I'm Adam right now, so I'm authenticating. You're going to get a nice little dialog window. And if you think about connecting to OneDrive in a desktop, it's not as fluid as this. This is really nice. So I choose recent. It'll show the recent files that I've interacted with today. And I'm going to go ahead and choose AdventureWorks. Click select. Here I'm going to change how I authenticate. We choose organizational account and we need to get signed in. So now we're authenticated. This button will light up. We click next. And then we choose the data we want. Just like the get data experience that we've been using as long as Power BI has been out. So we choose all the tables we want and then choose transform data. So now we're going to enter the Power Query experience.
So everything I know about Power Query, everything I can do in Power Query, the magic behind the data.
That's right.
I can do all of that with data marts.
Right here. Awesome. So it's all my ETL. So if I need to massage or transform the data, get intimate with the data, I can do it right here in Power Query. I don't need to do anything because this data is pretty nice. It's already coming from my data warehouse. And so I'm going to go ahead and click save. So it's loading my data. So you can see it's building the ETL, creating the relationship, starting the data load. And now it's loading my data. It's wrapping things up.
Like a Christmas present.
So now we're in the data mart experience. This is constantly saving. First thing I want to do is give it a different title. And now you can see all my data here. If I needed to do any type of transformations, I would head back over to Power Query. So you can go home and then you can choose transform data. It's kind of like the desktop experience.
Yeah.
And then what you can also do is directly inside the web browser.
This looks like the modeling tab inside of Power BI desktop.
Locally, let's say I'm a Mac user and I want to get as close to fidelity with the desktop and start doing some modeling experiences.
I can do it right here.
So let's zoom in. I just want to show you something really quick. Grab our product table and we'll grab our sales table. And I want to create a relationship. So I'll go find that product key, just like in the desktop, and I drop it. Dialog box, direct query, assume referential integrity. So I can do some inner joins. Click confirm, boom.
Simultaneously, what's happening is we've got our data mart. Think of this as a managed SQL server for you, right?
Yep.
That's running this.
So I don't have to provision. I don't need to go to Azure and create this SQL.
Power BI just manages this for you. That's the one layer that's here. The other layer on top of this is that there's an actual data set that it created, its indirect query mode. So this modeling experience that you're seeing as part of DataMarts is because it's working with that data set at the same time that it's working with the data on the SQL side.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Right, so it's doing both.
Once we have these done, now I can model this up. The properties window is there. I can do things with individual columns. Yeah. But look at this, Adam. What do you see right there?
New measure.
I can write DAX right here in the web browser. So if I just went here and I wanted to create a really simple measure, look at the IntelliSense. There you go. I just created a measure in the web browser against a model view.
Against the model view in DataMarts. And so if we connect it to that data set,
that measure would show up. And I never even use Power BI Desktop.
So now a natural question is going to be also, though, well, can I make a calculated column?
No, you can't. You can't create calculated columns or calculated tables.
But why would you want to do that when you've got the SQL database sitting right there, right? So just create it in the data mart. You add a column there, right? As far upstream as necessary, as far downstream as possible. I did that wrong. Go as far upstream as possible, as far downstream as necessary.
That's necessary.
You're going to do it in the data mart part, right? Yeah. In terms of adding a table or adding columns, you can do some calculation stuff from a Power Query perspective. Just write your own T-SQL to pull it in, or go against a view somewhere else as we're pulling it in. So those are all things that are options for you.
I want to show you one more thing.
All right.
I can create measures. I can model. I can also do row level security right here in the web browser. So everybody's claiming, oh, I got a MacBook. I can't do this. Yes, you can. That row level security is created in both layers, though.
Nice. So at the SQL layer, where the data is, and then the data set that gets created along with that's in direct query mode.
So it's one place. All these things just kind of wrapped up into one neat little feature, but there's something else I want to show you.
All right.
Imagine you just want to do some ad hoc analysis of this data. You don't know how to write SQL. You can use this view here, and what I can do is start dragging in a table. Boom. There goes Power Query.
Nice.
So for example, if I wanted to find the top sales order, I can bring in sales, I can bring in sales order, and then all I need to do is go here. These are just the Power Query steps. So much nicer than what we have in the desktop today, I gotta be honest with you. And so you choose the keys you wanna join on, you can choose the type of join you wanna do, click okay, then you can take a peek at this data, I can expand this out, and I only need sales order itself, and now go here and do a group by, and then I can say, give me the total sales, and do a sum, and then choose my sales amount, which would be somewhere right here. Click OK, do a quick sort. And I don't know how to write T-SQL anything, but it's right there.
It's right there.
But
what if you do know how to write SQL?
I can go right here in a web browser and start typing SQL Server. You see that IntelliSense?
Yeah,
it's IntelliSense. T-SQL, there's sales. Then I can do an inner join, sales order, just like that. And then I can run this. It'll run the result and give me everything. So I can do some grouping, some counts, some aggregations directly here in the web browser. And you can see how much time it's taken and how much memory it's gonna consume.
One other thing I'll just call out as a pro tip, just know that these dialogues here, you can move these, expand them. And so if you're back on the visual one as well, you can give yourself a little more room on either side. So I've got this data mark. What do I do with it?
To me, the possibilities are endless.
Okay.
Here, right? So I can start with this set of data, and it's for my department or for my group. I can use the built-in data set and start creating reports, or I can connect to the data warehouse itself. I mean, the data mart itself, and then bring in other data if I want to.
Right.
But we have this central repository. Or I'm gonna go back to the workspace, and then I'm gonna click on the ellipsis for the data mart itself, choose settings, and then you're gonna see this thing for service settings, kind of like the XML endpoint. And so if I copy this and open up Management Studio, choose Connect Database Engine.
You just have a SQL endpoint.
That's right, and choose Connect. Just gonna sign in as the current user here. And then over here, I'm connected to that underlying SQL Server. Now they only support read operations on the database right now. And so if I go and expand this out and I go to views, what you're gonna see is two schemas. You're going to see a meta schema where you can go and see the columns and the relationships and stuff like that. And then you'll see the actual model schema. So if I wanted to query this in Management Studio or some third party tool that allows you to connect directly to this, I can say select top 1000 rows. And then it's just going to open up a query already written for me. And it's going to give me the top 1000 rows out of that particular table.
We're using Management Studio in this case, but this could be Power BI Desktop, could be Excel, it could be
whatever tool you want to use.
Whatever.
Because it's just SQL Server.
It's just SQL at that point.
Yep.
Nice.
That's it.
So Patrick, a lot of people are asking me about, you know, this B2B type sharing.
Yeah.
So organization sharing with other organizations, that's something I can do with DataMarts?
Yeah, yeah. So if you go back to the workspace where the DataMart is, go into it. When you create your role, there's an option right here to assign people to those roles. I can assign not only internal, but external users to this. They'll get an email and they'll be able to use that data set.
Yeah.
Or I can just share that endpoint with them. If I do anything on that role to restrict data,
it'll be applied.
It'll be applied.
Right. And then all the security that happens from a workspace perspective in terms of access, things of that nature, that all comes into play here as well, because Power BI is managing that. We've got all this awesome DataMart technology. This is great, but why would I use a DataMart? And I talked before about this idea of bridging the gap between the business user and IT. If you need to stand up something that is like a SQL server, but you don't have access to Azure, you don't know what to do, and that's why you would want to use something like that. Because you can stand this up through the power of Power Query Online, get everything shaped into the way that you want it, and get it into a database so that we can leverage performance of something like that instead of going off of flat files directly. All right, so DataMarts are new. We want to know from you what questions you have. Have you used it? Have you tried it? Are you excited about it? Let us know in the comments below. If you'd like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both myself and
Patrick,
thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.